What's up? This is Rob Shameless with OutlawVideo.tv. I'm hanging out with Bury Your Dead.
Hello. I'm Mike.
What do you do, Mike?
I'm a singer. And you are?
My name's Slim.
And what do you do, Slim?
I don't know. You tell me.
I play the guitar, I believe.
That's right.
Yeah.
And we're the band Bury Your Dead. Well, we not, you know, there's more members, but we play for them. We're in it.
They're the faces and voices, especially Slim.
I'm the royal codpiece.
God piece goes over your dick balls.
This is gonna be great. You guys just put out a new record in like early summer, and it's very different from the Bury Your Dead that we've known from the Eulogy days to the early Victory days of Cubby with Tracks. And a lot of kids are like saying it's really new metal. There's actually a lot of kids, some friends of mine, that actually love the record. They like took to it instantly. They were like iffy at first, but then they were like, no, this record's freaking one of the best Bury Your Dead records ever made.
All right.
I mean, our biggest thing, if you listen to every record we've ever put out, starting with the record that came out on Alvarim and put out an Eulogy called You Had Me at Hello, you know, I mean, it was a straightforward record. It was in your face. It was aggressive. It was heavy. And you can even skip along to the newest record, and it has every single element that that record has now, but it's just more refined. You know, like, we've been a band for close to 10 years. It's like, it's physically impossible for me as a person and the people that are in this band doing this with me and doing this as a collective to not let 10 years of life influence the way that you write music and the way that you interpret what, I mean, because that's all that this, every record we've ever put out is basically just a diary that catalogs, audio version of a diary that catalogs from point A to point whatever the fuck that gets us to, you know, that next record.
True. Second record,
yeah.
As woo! The vocalist,
woo!
Vocalist number three.
No,
four.
Eight. Mark Hunley, Joe Kruko, Matt Brusso, Crafter, Mike Terry.
Five. Well, he's the third most famous in the bunch. Usually goes Brusso, then him.
So that's second.
Second, but then there's the guy from the first record.
And you don't even remember his name, so he's,
yeah,
so
he's,
he must not
he's,
be that famous.
He's not famous at all.
Yeah.
Those cookies rule.
Yeah. So yeah, he's the second famous, most memorable singer that you guys have had.
I'll take Matt.
Matt Brusso is teaching
children.
He's teaching kids in high school, so I mean,
he's making a difference somewhere in life. That's good.
That's right. I back it 100%. Matt Brusso.
We were sad when he left, because we all loved his haircut and him getting smashed in the face with your guitar head.
I didn't do that.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Somebody else did that. I would never do that in front of people.
Maybe when no one's looking.
When no one's looking, quite possibly.
Get out of my way.
No, I mean, it's cool, man. Like, Mike came into this
halfway through a tour.
Yeah.
Mike joined the band the day my aunt died, which is really weird. He flew into San Diego. I got a phone call. He killed it on the show. Then I got a phone call that night that she passed away around the same time that he showed up and we played, which is really weird.
Yeah.
That is really weird. My friend saw that show in San Diego. It was odd for me because I just saw you guys with a different singer. And I was just like,
Larry picked him up. That's the picture I have.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay.
He made bacon wrapped hot dogs.
Oh,
yes.
Hot dogs.
Shit can.
It was amazing. So, moving along, this new record is just phenomenal. Every record you guys have put out is phenomenal. There is a tuning that you tune your guitar to in A, and it's become like this new tuning to tune to, like For the Fallen Dreams and all these bands now, like tune to A. And a lot of kids have been like, you guys have influenced the metal hardcore sound from like Cover Your Tracks on.
Are you gonna give away the secret to it?
I'm not gonna give away the secret, but Joe Ellis from For the Fallen Dreams talks shit. Officially. I love the rest of the band, but fuck you, Joe Ellis.
We got
back
me.
To the question.
Anyways.
Back to the question at hand. Yeah, yeah, I mean, Korn tuned to fucking A or whatever, you know what I mean? But and lower, you know.
Lower.
It's just kind of.
But a
it
lot
just
of
feels good.
Feels
yeah.
Feels
for
good
us,
to hear.
For us, I mean, it's not always about. It didn't start to. I mean, if you listen to any of our stuff, it's all rhythmic. You know what I mean? It's all rhythm based.
Yeah.
So it's like, the lower we tuned and we started finding out, like, it just made it that much heavier. And we're like, cool.
Exactly.
So fucking
cover,
fish
cover your tracks.
It was in A sharp.
A sharp. It was in A sharp, and there's a lot of bands that tune to A sharp, but not a lot of bands know this. Every band, there's a lot of kids who are like, oh yeah, Bury Your Dead, A sharp, A sharp, A, but Disembodied was one of the first bands to ever do that. And let me ask you this, was bands like Disembodied and those early hardcore bands like All Out War and all that, like, what were your influences growing up, you know?
Archangel.
A lot of people kind of don't see the European hardcore influence in this band. This band's highly influenced by European hardcore bands like Drift and Copykill and Archangel and
Heaven Shall Burn
and Angel Crew, and, you know, tons of, I mean, even Caliban, you know what I mean? Like, bands that we grew up listening to. Those are just the European bands that we kind of grew up listening to. And then you got, like, all the bands that I grew up listening to coming from, you know, a Boston hardcore scene, kind of Northeast, Connecticut, New York, and Boston. It's like, we had bands like, I was fortunate enough to grow up listening to bands and going to shows, seeing Hunger Demons, Reach the Sky, Converge, you know, Sworn Enemy, 40 Days Rain, you know what I mean?
Wow.
Blood for Blood.
I haven't heard that one in a while.
Blood for Blood's playing the American Hardcore Fest.
I'm gonna just go and lose my mind. Great American Hardcore Fest.
You can fight
Great American fight. Hardcore Fest.
What's the
everybody?
Date on that? Great American Hardcore Fest, Boston, Massachusetts. Revere, right? It's in Revere? Yeah, go. 16th,
17th, 18th. ICC Church.
That's the pre-show.
So, it's going to be good times. So, yeah. You heard it here from Bury Your Dead. You need to go.
Seriously.
Do it.
I'm going to be there. So, you should be there.
It's awesome. You guys...
Not if we can just get Rob out there with his bacon wrap hot dogs. We'll be...
Hey, if I could get out there, hey, if these guys would take me home with them, I'd buy bacon wrap hot dogs and cook them for all the bands. We'd have
bacon
a barbecue.
Hot dogs? Just asking for a heart attack.
Hey, Slim ate like 5 of them, and he's still alive. He is still alive.
He's a machine. He's not even a real human. He's made of riffs.
I'm made of riffs. Riffs
he
and
is made
beer.
Of riffs.
Yeah.
That's about it.
So.